suppose Raven may have endlessly repeated the word nevermore, but did that Corvid acutely understand the finality of death and the act of mourning? Quoth the Raven, maybe? Hi everyone, it's Natalia for D News. Dealing with the loss of a loved one is no doubt a painful time, but are humans the only species that mourn their dead? Recently, a female snub-nosed monkey in a Chinese nature reserve was observed to fall ill. The dominant male in the group remained with her as her symptoms appeared to grow worse. At one point, the female monkey fell from the tree and landed on the rocky ground. As she lay injured, the male was seen examining her and began to groom her while others began to do the same. She eventually died, and the group moved on. Researchers buried the female a kilometer away, and the following day, the group of monkeys returned. The male went to the spot where the female had died, only to discover that she was not there. He waited two or so minutes until he solemnly moved on with his troop. Was this monkey feeling grief? Some scientists argue that assigning commonly associated human characteristics to animals like love, grief, and empathy is anthropomorphizing them or attributing human personalities to animals without sufficient evidence. However, other scientists don't see the comparison of these behaviors far-fetched, even finding it species-centric to assume that these traits can only belong to humans. Just because a monkey can't write a sonnet about their loss doesn't necessarily mean they aren't capable of empathy. Barbara J. King, a biological anthropologist, wrote a book specifically about the bereavement of our animal brethren entitled How Do Animals Grieve? In King's book, she details multiple species that mourn the loss of members of their group, including a dolphin mother who lost her calf, a group of elephants mourning their matriarch's death, and how a domestic cat wailed for weeks after the death of her sister. Although these examples can be considered anecdotal evidence, King has said that the database of stories from peer-reviewed sources of various animal species exhibiting empathetic behavior is growing, which will no doubt aid in research and understanding of animal emotion, including grief. Some of the best documented animal mourners are our closest genetic relatives, chimpanzees. At Cameroon's Sanaga-Yong Chimpanzee Rescue Center, a group of chimps have been seen gathering around an older female who had recently died. She had been a maternal figure to many of the other chimps at the sanctuary, and it appeared that the group were paying their respects. Similarly, a deceased chimpanzee at a sanctuary in Zambia was surrounded by a group of chimps who gently touched, smelled, and lightly groomed his body. Volunteers noted that the chimpanzees were not only processing his death, they were mourning a friend. Chimpanzee mothers who have lost infants have also been documented on several occasions carrying their dead offspring around for days, sometimes weeks. These mothers appear to care for them and even try to revive them. This is possible evidence of these animals understanding or processing death. This behavior has also been documented in gorillas, macaques, and baboons. Another group of animals that have been reported to mourn their dead are corvids. Corvids, or crows, ravens, magpies, rooks, and jays, have been observed having makeshift funerals for their deceased relatives. Some have witnessed ravens dropping twigs, grass, and other offerings on their dead. However, some skeptics assert that these funerals may be less about mourning and more about understanding what felled their corvid comrade. Was it murder? Well, regardless of their intention, it can again be possible evidence of animals understanding and reacting to death. There's still more research needed to truly understand the emotional lives of animals, and there's a chance we may never really know how deeply they feel. Now that we know how some animals deal with death, here's a fascinating video about how humans both preserve and learn from deceased animals while preparing them for museum collections.
So I'm gonna start just by separating the feathers out and making an incision down basically along the breastbone of the bird. And now I'm gonna just start separating the skin from the body. It's almost like pulling off a sock or pulling off a sweatshirt over your head.
What do you think? Do you think animals mourn their dead? Will your cat grieve over your imminent demise, or is Mr. Mittens just counting the days until he can eat you? Subscribe to D News and let us know in the comments below. Thanks for watching.